Yes, yes.
Wow.
Welcome back to our final hour of 1D Day.
Yes!
We don't want it to end!
Come on!
I love this show! Sorry.
I think we're going to look at some fans from Holland on the VT.
Let's have a look. We're going to play a little game.
Look at that.
Let's do this.
Unbelievable.
Well, it looks like the Dutch fans want to play a massive game of rock, paper, scissors with us.
Yep. Something I've always wanted to do, lads.
I remember we should see if we get involved.
I'm ready for that.
Does everybody know the rules?
Yeah. Is it 3-2-1 go or 1-2 go?
3-2-1.
You can do 3-2-1 or 1-2-3, depending on whichever one you
want. I've done a quick sneeze.
Okay.
So play along. What are you all going for, gang?
Towards the camera? Towards the camera, Ben, is that right? Okay.
How are we all going to do the same thing?
No, but we're playing against them.
Anyone here?
You've got.
So look this way. It's this way.
We'll see who wins.
Do we have to go at the same time?
Oh, they've gone for rock. We've all been beaten.
That's rock.
All of us have been beaten.
Cool. Can we play again? Let's play again. One more.
Ready?
Okay, right. Three, two, one, go. Yep.
Yep. Ready?
Right, okay. Waiting for the VT.
Here we go.
Okay.
Three, two, one.
Yeah!
Yes!
Yes! Oh, and we
did that. I win. One more. Let's go again.
You've got to beat them.
Right, okay. Three, two, one.
I've got again.
I
lost again.
So what did we win?
Drew.
Oh, it's just all for fun.
We won two and lost everyone else.
Okay.
What? Yeah.
Great.
Yeah. Okay, fair enough.
Well, that was interesting.
So thank you to the Netherlands for playing a giant game.
It's the Dutch way.
It is the Dutch way to play a large game of paper, scissors and rock.
Now we are going to move on to...
The USA VT. I think we're going to move to the USA VT. I've just got a feeling it's the USA VT.
Is it the US fund?
I have a feeling in my ear.
I'm just waiting for it to go to the US VT.
The first One Direction show in America was in Chicago in Rosemont. My mom let me skip school that day.
I woke up about 5:30, and then I was gonna go meet up with my friend at the hotel that they were staying at. It was like crazy if you think I'm in the same building as them.
I could easily say it was one of the best days of my life. You get to see the people that you've been in love with forever.
We love your face!
I remember like them announcing 10 more seconds to go, and like my heart just like stopped beating.
We were screaming and we were so loud. I don't think they were expecting that kind of reaction. Their first show in America.
I think the whole point of it is that they make music to bring people together. And I like couldn't imagine my life without them because I would be a completely different person.
We had One Direction at the Natick Mall for a signing on March 4th. We all went to the concert, and we got home at 12 o'clock, and then we woke up at 2 o'clock and got ready for the signing.
I thought about all their music, and I was like, what it would mean to me just to meet them. It was just such an exciting thought.
The line was around the mall.
All you heard about was how like many people showed up.
So this is my grandma. She brought me to the signing.
So nervous, and like, if we meet them, how are we going to act?
When I first got to the table, it was kind of like shock. And then I like went on to Harry. He was like, hi love, how are you? And I just started bawling my eyes out.
I got to hug Harry, even though I wasn't supposed to. I did it anyway.
We met them. We got to experience something really huge.
Camping out days before.
Camped out for 14 hours.
The doors opened at 7 a.m. It was like a madhouse. There were shoes everywhere. Like, people were losing their shoes. Once we got there, I could, like, hear these voices. And I, like, freaked out. I'm like, oh, my God, it's sound check.
And it was just, like, this overwhelming feeling.
I just felt like, oh, they're here. It's real. It's going to happen.
I actually started crying. And it was so hot, I literally started passing out because I was so anxious. Everybody's there for the same purpose, and we're all so happy, and we're all so supportive of each other.
Flown from Dallas to New York, and from New York to Dallas, and Dallas to LA, all for my boys. Mm-hmm. I love them.
One of the best things about being a One Direction fan is that you get the opportunity to meet people from all over the world.
They really changed our lives. I wasn't friends with them, like, at all, and now we're, like, sisters, basically.
Yeah.
And I've been waiting for this time to come around.
What's the dog's name?
And
we're going to find out. We're going to find out in a minute.
There we go.
Okay, our next guest is a close personal friend of ours, and most importantly, our boss, it's Simon Cowell!
Actually, you are my bosses now.
Oh,
here we go. It's all kind of turned around.
On camera, then.
Thank you very much for coming to join us today here for 1D Day. You're cutting it a little close, though, aren't you? I mean, you've only got about 35 minutes left. What does that mean?
Yeah, you're a little
bit late. What does that mean? I mean, who's writing this?
It's like an anchor man when they're feeding that absolute
I'm going to turn my ear off, man. I'm just going to blend it.
Do you remember the discussions you had about putting us together?
I do.
Can we talk about it?
Let's have an honest, real...
Here on TV.
None of this TV crap.
Right, so what do you want to ask?
Well, whose idea actually was it?
It was my idea.
Right.
Yeah.
Until we meet Louis.
Yeah, although we did ask Nicole today and she did say that it was her idea. So
do you know what? I've actually got the footage. I'll send it to you one day, what really happened that day.
Was there anybody else that you thought was going to be in the band, a potential?
No. I mean, it was really weird.
Tom Richards. No way.
No. This is the mom,
man. He'll be watching this.
No way. You're a great guy. No, he wasn't. And I'll tell you what happened was, I suddenly realised on the show we had no bands, no groups. And I didn't want you guys to go. And I just said, why don't we put these five into a group? And it literally took 10 minutes.
Thanks, anyway.
Yeah, cheers for doing that,
cheers
Simon, because now we're here, so it's great, really.
Just done a 7-hour live stream.
And it kind of worked, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's got nice.
Decent idea.
Still all right.
It's one of them good ones, you
No, but I was disappointed, because I actually thought all of you were going to get through solo artists. So something kind of went wrong in the middle. You want to
maybe
explain
it was
what
the song
happened?
Choices.
Yeah, I think
yeah,
it was
right.
Manager.
Michael Bublé impersonators, that's what it was, remember that?
This one I had to drag from the back of the theatre.
Yeah, I remember that.
You want to see him dancing? No, world class.
Exactly.
He's choreographed everything now.
Yeah, reliving the good old days. Anyway, we've got a little game set up for you now, Simon. We know you're a fan of dogs.
I love dogs.
You love dogs.
Yeah. You got two new dogs, haven't you?
Yeah, Squiddly and Diddly.
Yeah, I've seen them, yeah.
Really?
Good names.
Oh, great names.
Is that a sign of the softer Simon?
Definitely.
Yes.
I've got another little Simon on the way, so this is prep.
Yes. How long did it take you to think of those names, Simon?
Well, Squiddly Diddly.
That one came first.
That was one of my favourite cartoons. I haven't definitely said he's going to be called Simon, but I can't think of a better name.
No.
I seriously can't.
Right then, we've got a dog that we'd love you to meet today. Could we bring
what sort of dog is it?
Dog, please. Could we ask what the dog's name is?
Yeah, what's the dog's name?
What's the dog's name?
Well done, dog.
Gabby.
Gabby.
Hi, Gabby.
Hello, Gabby.
How are you?
That's a very unusual cast, Gabby. What sort of dog is Gabby? I'm going to sit over here.
Okay, so
hi, Gabby.
I'm not 100% sure. I think that the way it works is the dog will bark. She will bark if the answer is correct, and she will be silent if the answer is not true.
Right. So she barks if it's a yes.
Yeah, you've got to.
The dog is a celebrity person. Right? The dog.
Not actually,
this one.
The dog is thinking of someone.
Okay, so I've got to guess who the celebrity is.
You have to say, like, are you a man? And if it's a yes, then the dog will bark. And if it's a no, the dog will make no noise.
Why is she staring at me like
that? I can't believe it's Simon from the telly.
Yeah, right.
She's starstruck.
Are you ready?
I'm ready to go.
Okay, are you ready? Let's go.
Okay, is it a boy? Okay, is it a girl?
Okay.
Okay.
Is it a dog?
Is it a transvestite? Okay, this isn't going well.
Okay, let's try again.
Okay, is he a singer? Okay, that means no. Are you an actress?
Never worked with kids or animals.
Yep.
Right, so this person is nothing.
It's a lovely dog, but it just doesn't seem to be working.
Let's start again. Have I seen one of your movies recently? Okay, do you like One Direction?
She's slightly nervous.
No, there was a nod there.
That was a nod, like One Direction. Okay, help me here. Maybe she's just not responding to me.
I think we're going to have to move on. Great dog,
just ask her a question.
Gabby is a little nervous, I'm afraid.
What if Gabby sat on me?
Come on, Simon.
Bring Gabs over.
Come on, baby. Let's try again.
Okay.
Okay,
right. Gabs. Oh, Simon, you hold on to her.
I'll woof.
Okay. That's a better idea. Okay.
Where are the gifts? We've got some gifts.
Are you a boy?
Where are they? Show me the
gifts.
The dog has one of the gifts, by the way.
Where are we looking?
Yes, right, you're a girl.
So, Simon, as you said just now, you've got one on the way. So,
yes.
We thought we'd.
He's got one on the way, everyone!
Woo! One on the way!
Because that worked really well. I mean, seriously, this is a TV show here.
Well, anyway, we bought you some baby gifts.
Yeah. Simon, don't be ungrateful, please. Listen up.
I've got Gabby.
Okay, here
I'm
we go.
Happy. I think fell flat in front of millions of people. I'm fine.
They are.
Just humiliated myself for millions of people.
What more could you want, Simon, than this fantastic gift with baby
you.
Girls of each of our faces?
faces on.
Lauren, come here. Come here. Come on, Lauren.
That way, dear. Look,
Lauren.
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 Come on.
Come here.
Come
here.
Bring her up.
Hello,
You're
Lauren.
You're part of this.
How are you?
Lauren, everyone.
Lots of them.
Inside.
Okay, Lauren, what do you think?
Take a seat, Lauren. Take a seat.
Please,
sit down.
Make yourself at home.
I'm more comfortable.
What do you think?
There's
me. Obviously, you're going to use this one every day.
No, 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 for me. To the baby.
Yeah. That's Liam. He's my favourite member.
This one might attract a bit of attention.
Thank you, guys. That's adorable.
Are they cute? Yeah.
Twinkle.
And not lost to stick in anywhere at all.
Now, if we knew what that word meant, it would have been.
I know, but it means loving yourself. But thank you very much,
Steve. Call the baby Simon. Thanks, Lauren. Round of applause for Lauren.
Okay, call
the baby.
Thank
you very much.
She is
pregnant. She is pregnant.
Nice to see you.
Right then.
That was amazing, by the way. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much. Well, thank you very much for coming in today.
Good luck, guys.
Sorry about the game.
Don't worry about it.
Right then, we've got a quick film of promo now for our DVD, which comes out at Christmas. So this is for you to enjoy now. Once again, thank you to Simon. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you, Simon.
Welcome! Everybody, can we just give it up for the boss, Simon Cowell, please?
What a great man. Great man.
Okay, so we haven't done this in a while, so let's go back to the...
I haven't done this yet today.
Have you not?
I haven't had a randomizer yet.
Oh, we've done a few.
Let's go to the randomizer, see who's got a question for us.
See what we've got.
Hi, guys. Hope you're well. Got a question for Harry. I was just wondering if my girlfriend can have your telephone number.
Can I just interject there? I must say, actually, Harry, he's taken the crown of you for the most morbid speaker. That was you originally, and I think now Andy Murray's got that crown.
Can my girlfriend have your mobile number?
Can she?
That wasn't Zane asking, by the way. That was Andy Murray.
Yeah.
Okay, next question.
Hello, boys. I hope you're enjoying your 1D day. I've got a question, and it's for Liam. Now, a little birdie told me that apparently I was the first person that you had your photo taken with. I've got this photograph here. There we are, looking ridiculously young. So thank you for bringing this to my attention. I want to know who, apart from me, obviously, is your favourite person that you've had your picture taken with. Thank you, Liam. Thank you, boys. See you soon.
I don't think I'll ever forget that moment of that photo, lads. You can imagine why.
Tell us a story, Liam. Come on, elaborate,
it was.
Don't be a gentleman.
Let's go back to the photo again, shall we?
Can we have a look at the photo?
Let's bring the photo back up here, shall we? 3, 2, 1. Where is the photo? It's coming soon. Here we go.
There it is. Look at Liam's hair.
Gorgeous.
That was.
Gorgeous. Gorgeous.
Liam's there we are.
Oh, he's lovely, don't
Liam, your hair looks great.
So what that was there, lads, was my first ever audition for X Factor. Where I ran into
Mrs.
Holly.
Nice dinner jacket, or is that a waistcoat?
It's a waistcoat, actually. Okay.
Right, nice. Should we take another question?
Yeah,
let's go. Another randomizer.
Sorry. Oh.
Right, guys, you can't come through a football team without a few practical jokes or a prankster. So I was just wondering, who's the biggest prankster out of you?
It's me, right?
It's me.
Ryan Giggs, everybody.
Ryan Giggs.
Giggs!
Running down the way.
Giggs, you wanted to know who the prankster was. I'm going to say Louis
is the prankster.
It's Louis Giggs.
Yeah.
Thank you, cool.
Louis. Thank you, Ryan.
You once pulled Niles. No, we've said this before, haven't we?
Yeah, do you know what I mean? Everyone always has watched the best prank.
We, didn't we put like some warm water on Niall?
Yeah, we tried to make Niall wee himself once by pouring warm water on him and he woke up and wasn't very happy. So shall we take one more question?
Okay. Thanks, Ryan.
Let's go, one more question.
One more.
So, 1D boys, honestly, who do you think is the best boy band of all time?
One Direction.
Louis Walsh. Everybody judging the X Factor.
Louis Walsh.
He told us we were going to be the next big boy band.
Yep.
He was wrong.
Who do you think now? Best boy band.
Are you related
of all
to Louis
time?
Walsh now?
No, I'm actually not. No. Okay. We happen to be from the same country, but we're not related. Oh. I think best boy band ever. I'm going to go Backstreet Boys.
Okay.
I'm going to go for NSYNC.
Okay. Boys?
I'm going to go for a Boys to Men.
Ooh. Okay.
I'm going to go Boys to Men as well, you know.
Thank nice,
you.
Good choice. It's good, that.
I'm going to go NSYNC. I mean, I don't really know.
You're
going to
go Busted.
What about Take
That? Oh, of course
I've
done
Busted. Busted.
Liam,
you love Busted. Actually.
But the less boy bandy, do you know what I mean?
Mac Busted.
A massive thank you to our celebrity guests for all of our questions. We're going to hang over here to hear is Scott Mills.
Cooking on the last hour of 1D show. So, it's kind of a big hangout now with a difference. What we're going to do is speak to some huge 1D fans from Asia, and in order to test the guys' knowledge about that fine continent, we're going to play a little food-based game. And as the guys have been on air now for more than 6 hours, the notion of food, believe me, is very appealing. It's been liquids only. So this is how it works, right? Okay. Look, under here, some food.
I feel like it's a bush tucker trial.
It is almost bush tuckerish.
Yeah,
so, okay, two dishes specially prepared for the hangout. One is a gorgeous Asian delicacy, and under the other is your personal food nightmare. So what's going to happen is they're going to be set a question, one of the guys on the hangout about their country. Get it right, and you will get to have some amazing Asian food. However, get it wrong, and you will probably end up with a horrible stomach ache just to celebrate the last hour
maybe
of 1D Day. So, yeah, and maybe that.
Yeah.
So the pressure is on. So, Zane, you're up first. Please take a seat.
Go on, Zane. Go on.
Okay, let's not keep these fans waiting. Let's say hello to Korea. Korea, are you there?
Yes, hi.
Hi, Korea. Oh look, there they are.
Oh,
clear some space for the screen. Hi, Korea, how are you?
Hi, I'm good, how are you?
Hello.
Very good, thank you. Okay, so what is your question? Try and get this right, please, Zane.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay. In Korea, White Day is a holiday where Koreans dress in completely white clothing and walk around like ghosts. True or false?
Can you repeat the question?
True or false? Can we have the question one more time, please?
Okay. In Korea, White Day is a holiday where Koreans dress in completely white clothing and walk around like ghosts. True or false?
You get that? So in Korea, White Day is March the 14th. It's where the men give a candle to the women. Was that right?
Is it?
I think that's the second question.
Oh, that's the second question.
First one is they're dressed in white and they walk around like ghosts.
That's
is that
it.
True or false?
Thank you, chef.
Absolutely.
Zane.
I reckon the first one is false.
You think the first one, okay. This is the one we said.
They don't dress in white and they don't walk around like ghosts.
No.
Okay. So we're saying, Korea, that it's false.
It's false.
Yes!
Yes! Okay, chef, so he gets good food.
That means you get to eat some good food, and we got a classic Korean dish, the scallion pancake japun.
Nice.
There you go.
Into that.
Oh, Zane.
Thank you very much, Korea. He got it right. Thank you very much for your question.
A little soy dipping sauce right there. Go for it.
Now, that looks really good. I don't think any of the other guys are going to volunteer. So, Harry?
You want to see if what you would have had to eat if you got it wrong?
Yeah, please.
You want to see if you got it wrong, what you had to eat?
I would have liked to have seen,
with some nice deep-fried grasshoppers, what I personally feed my lizard every day. Stop. There you go. So you got lucky.
You actually have a lizard.
So scared now, seeing
yes, you want to do one, Harry?
I'll do it.
Go on.
All right, Harry. You're next,
deep
though. So you
got
the next question.
They're deep-fried.
Deep-fried.
Yes, they are.
Everything tastes good when it's deep-fried.
I've had some salt and vinegar ones these for my sister.
Okay, grasshopper doesn't taste good when it's deep-fried.
Okay, grasshopper not good.
Unless you're
not having one.
No,
that
bro.
Looks better. Okay, are we ready for our next country?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so hello to Taiwan.
Hi.
Hello, Taiwan. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. I'm feeling extraordinary, or as I like to say, extraordinary.
Extraordinary.
Hey, tips.
Have you been watching us on all of 1D Day?
Yeah, I woke up at 3 a.m.
Fun.
Dedication.
That is dedication.
Harry, this is you.
Okay, so can we have your question, please, as Harry takes a seat? He's just eaten a deep-fried grasshopper. Oh, it wasn't good. Okay, so Taiwan, what's your question?
All right, the question is, one of the countries with the highest density of convenience stores is Taiwan. True or false?
Okay, so one of the countries with the highest density of convenience stores is Taiwan. True or false? So, you know, like...
I go, yeah.
Convenience stores.
The last one was false, so my logic there is go true on
this. You think?
Good logic.
I wouldn't. I'd go false again.
Think about it, Styles.
I think China might have one of the highest.
Yeah, because it's got...
When you say one of the highest, that's quite open.
One of the highest is a bit vague.
I'm going to say true.
Just make an answer. True
I'm going to say true.
True or false? Taiwan, what's the answer?
True.
All right.
Yeah, he gets the good food. Okay, what is it, chef?
And your good food is a classic Thai boba iced tea. That's got some boba pearls in there. Give it a little swirl. There you go. All right.
What's boba?
Boba is a tapioca pearl. So it's a tapioca starch. They pearlize it, and that's why they get the big straws. You can actually suck up some of the tapioca pearl. No?
Yum. All right. This is his least favorite good food ever.
Right.
It's kind of like a bit frog spawny.
It is kind of chewy. Really doesn't have a lot of flavor.
Right,
okay?
So that was the luxury item.
That was the luxury.
You ready for the bad item?
What's the bad one?
The bad one was a tuna milkshake.
I think I'd rather have that. I would rather have that.
No, I'm all right.
No, it's moving on to that too.
Okay, Taiwan, thanks so much for your question on 1D Day. Thank you.
It's got tuna in it.
Let me see.
That's amazing.
I quite like it.
God, Scott.
Okay, good. It smelled like a good idea, it really wasn't. Okay, two down, three to go. So, Niall is next. Make some noise for Niall, he's next on the challenge. Okay, we know how it works by now. Good food, bad food, true, false. Hi, Indonesia.
Hi.
Hey.
Yeah, me too.
How are you? I love you. How are you?
Oh, colorful.
Are you good?
Hey.
What time is it in Indonesia right now?
It's 8:41.
In the morning?
8:40, yeah.
Oh, wow. So you've been up all night watching 1D Day. Thank you so much.
Oh.
I love all your stuff around you as well. Like, it's a shrine. Okay, what is your question to the boys?
Okay, Indonesia is one of the world's largest exporters of front legs. True, is it true or false?
Okay, so Indonesia, one of the largest exporters of frog legs. True or false?
Come on, Niall, you know this one.
What are you saying, Niall?
True.
Me too.
I need an answer.
I'm gonna go. Yeah. I'm gonna go false.
Okay. Niall says the answer is false. What's the answer, please?
The answer is true.
Listen to that laugh. It's like, okay.
So what would bad food, you would have eaten if you got the question right?
Yes.
Jesus.
What you would have eaten would have been a classic Indonesian style fried rice.
That's good, right?
Right. Wonderful stuff, right?
That's Harry's.
So you can taunt him with that because he can't get any of it. Taunt him. Okay.
No, you could just take it.
Okay. Now that you got the question wrong. Some brains.
Of what?
Yes. Sheep's brains.
Sheep's brains.
Sheep's brains.
Okay, good luck, Niall. Get it down,
Come on, Niall.
One more. It's not bad, actually.
No?
Oh, my God.
Some water, please.
It tastes like what I imagine cat food would taste like.
It's quite nice cat food.
Here's what flavour
you have. What you could do in this.
Yeah, get some good stuff.
Okay, he's having some of the good stuff as well. Indonesia, thank you so much. That was a great question, and you look amazing. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, now I think it's Louis now.
Oh, I'm last.
Yes, Louis next.
Okay. I really don't want to get this wrong, please, Scott.
If anybody beat me,
Harry has grasshopper in his teeth, so this has been a good item. I drank tuna milkshake.
Oh, don't say that.
Oh, they're getting worse.
Okay, now let's chat to Malaysia. Hi, Malaysia.
Hi.
Ow, you're loud. How are you? You okay?
Apa kabar?
That's Malay for how are you?
Very good.
We're very good.
Are you enjoying
it? We're good.
I'm yeah.
Okay. What's are you enjoying 1D day?
Yes, it's been a blast.
It has been a blast. Okay, right, Malaysia, give us your question, please, and thanks very much for joining us today. What's your question?
Malaysia is home to one of the world's largest roundabouts. True or false?
Malaysia is home to one of the world's largest roundabouts.
Oh, hang on a minute.
True or false? You know your roundabouts.
Yeah, I'm sure I've already learned about this.
Have you?
No, Niall, of course I've never learnt about a roundabout in Malaysia.
Like a specific spaghetti junction kind of thing.
Boys, I mean...
In Birmingham.
I mean, no one's... I really don't want to get this shot.
I need an answer.
I really don't want to get this shot.
I need an answer.
I go false, mate.
Go true.
But it's so random to go false. Like, it's a random thing to...
I think you're thinking about it too much.
Okay, I'm going to say true. I really don't want to get this wrong.
Okay.
Can you just lie, please?
Is Malaysia home to one of the world's largest roundabouts? True or false?
Of course it is!
What's the answer?
Yes!
Yes!
She's playing with me.
Yes! Bit of a delay, but you were right to go true. So, Chef, what have we got?
So, for the true answer, you get wonderful Indonesian chicken satay.
Oh, yes. Coconut milk.
Yes.
There you go.
Excellent. Enjoy.
What would we have had, though?
Can we see what the bad food was?
The bad food was a pig's foot.
Yeah!
Oh.
Pig's feet.
He's going to try it. Try it. Try it.
I've seen this at Over Celebrity.
Try it.
Mate, that is disgusting. I'm
you
not
take him in.
Yeah.
Oh. Anybody?
Don't hide behind me.
That's the end of 1D day.
Pig's foot!
It stinks so bad. Can we do one more? We're doing one more food. Okay, Liam.
One more.
Liam, sit down.
I'm so sorry.
I'm so sorry that you got pig's foot there.
I've got pig's foot.
Okay. Hello, Singapore.
Hey guys.
Hey Singapore. How are you?
Oh, I'm so scared.
We've just been throwing pig's foot around and it smells really disgusting. Anyway, what's your question, please, Singapore?
My question is, Singapore has a road with Harry's surname in it. True or false?
Could you repeat the question for us, please?
Okay. Singapore has a road with Harry's surname in it. True or false?
Okay, so Singapore has a road with Harry's surname in it. True or false, Liam? When you give your answer, please show your workings.
Quite a lot of... I'm going... what was the last one?
The last one was true.
That doesn't mean anything.
Yeah, but it's followed a pattern so far.
Sure,
so
okay.
I think they'd be like, we can't have a pattern, so it's going to have to be true twice in a row. I'm telling you, Liam.
I'm going to go against the grain. I'm going to go false.
Ooh.
Hey, look at me. I'm quirky.
Oh. Okay. So, Singapore, is it true or false?
It's false.
Yeah! Yes, okay, so Chef, what have we got?
Since you got the question right, have a wonderful Hunan-style chicken rice.
Come to me.
Oh, yes. That's good.
Now, I'm going to have to use a fork, so I'm sorry about that.
Is the bad food worse than the pig's foot before?
No, the bad food is, we'll see.
Okay, can we reveal that
see what the bad
what
food
is?
It's some chocolate-covered Marmite. Marmite-covered chocolate.
Oh, my God, yeah. That's a
copper. That's fine.
That's a copper. I could have got pig's foot. I mean, he's got chocolate here.
Yeah, I'm just told.
It's some favourites. Look at Liam. Really
thank you very much, Chef.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Liam, eat it.
Good, guys.
Pain Train is eating it. Thank you very much, Singapore. Thank you. And let's say thank you to all the fans for getting involved. That was brilliant. Thank you. Niall, over to you.
Okay, let's check what the best message and best picture of the day actually was.
And here we are with the best picture. Go, no.
Ah.
Ooh.
Here we go. Oh, that's a great picture, you, Liam, there.
Yeah.
Oh, are these just some of the pictures of the day?
Yeah.
Not one specific.
Like this one.
There's plenty.
Oh. That one's wicked at the bottom there.
Yeah, somebody in the beach.
This one's good. We like this a lot. We have this one from Austria. People have painted their faces. We have the Wheel of Wonder
Melbourne
in the sky. That one's really cool. The little muffins there.
Yeah. Like some good muffins. Baking going.
Loving
there.
The face painting, Emma and Julia.
This is Harry.
That girl seems to be reading the album.
And your scorer.
These girls from England.
Right, can we get someone to scroll? Do you want me to go and scroll down so you can see more?
Five sausages of summer.
Five sausages and some. We have Selma here.
Oh, hang on a minute, Liam. We've lost picture now. What's going on, mate?
Here we are. We're back.
Hey, look at that one.
We have someone recreating the story of my life video up there. Not anymore.
There's my hair purple.
There's Niall's purple hair.
There we go. Look at that.
That is a good one.
Spitting image.
Thank you to Clara.
Kira, great job.
We have
Sashi. Right, come on, boys. Let's go and have a look at the album.
All right.
Let's have a look at the album. Let's have a listen to the album. Let's have a speak to the people listening to it. It's as easy as that.
These girls have been in here for ages.
I was so scared for that food.
Well, all right, love, it was just a joke. Come to our skin.
Hello.
Come on in, guys. Stand yourself in the middle. How did you find it, boys? Boys, that is an awful way to start. But I was directing that at these four lovely gentlemen here. How was the album?
It was great. Really good. Amazing. I really loved it, guys.
All of them.
All of them?
All of them. And actually, probably my favorite, You and I.
Nice.
You didn't know you were coming here tonight,
well,
did you?
No, I didn't.
So,
funny you should say that. Well, actually, the next song that people at home are going to get to listen to is You and I. Here it is.
Okay, enough about us. Let's see what Columbia did.
No?
Oh, okay.
Oh, no.
We're going to ignore that.
We're going to change. Yeah.
Cool.
Thank you
for that, Ben.
Okay, act of kindness. This is done by Office Depot, I believe.
Yes, it is.
Everyone's been sending in their acts of kindness.
Yeah.
Boys, have you ever done anything kind, Niall?
I like to do many kind things a day. Yes. It's nice to be nice to people.
Okay, cool. Should we go to the VT?
Let's do this.
Please. Let's go.
For the 1D plus OD anti-bullying awareness and how the little things can change people.
I made these posters to spread the word around my school based on the 1D product quotes. Just a little inspiration and awareness for everyone.
The words of bullies aren't even worth two pennies, so don't worry about those crooks because they only go by the...
With this One Direction notebook, I will be writing positive little notes on each page and tearing them out and placing them around town.
My idea to raise money for anti-bullying awareness is a day titled Music Against Bullying.
Pull out a 1D pen and let your mind take a cleanse. Let your feelings out on paper rather than me and a weeper.
This day would feature speakers who speak with anti-bullying as well as ones who use music to do that, which I feel could make a great impression.
I wanted this kindness to spread like wildfire, so I did this on the same day as an anti-bullying seminar was at my school.
And I think that it's a message that everyone should hear. If you're being bullied, you don't deserve it, and if you're not being bullied, then you should try to help.
What does kindness mean to you?
To me, it means to be kind to everyone you meet, no matter what. When you're kind, you should not bully. Bullying affects people way worse than you think.
I can, and you can too, write notes to people who really need them, such as, stay strong, everything will be okay, and you're not alone.
When people ask me about my One Direction bracelets or my One Direction notebook and binder, I tell them about 1DP's anti-bullying program. This is important to me because I was bullied.
I created a 1D plus OD anti-bullying photo booth at my school's homecoming carnival where they could express their unique selves.
I'm doing this to remind everyone to celebrate being original because we're all unique in our own special way.
Day after day, I will flip these positive notes around town, reminding people anonymously that they're worth it and that it's the little things that make them who they are.
By doing this, we can not only raise money, but provide a united front for anti-bullying awareness and truly make a difference.
Everything will be okay.
This can put a smile on someone's face.
Remember, everyone needs to be brave to stop bullying.
My goal is to help somebody somewhere smile each day. I know that we can come together against bullying.
When given the choice between being right or being kind, you should always choose kind. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, everybody. It actually is amazing for us that we were so happy to get involved in this. And how much have we actually raised there, Harry?
Well, we have three girls here who have won the competition to come and accept a cheque.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello,
guys.
On behalf of Office Depot.
Yeah.
So a massive thank you to Office Depot and to them. Are you ready to see how much we raised?
Drum roll, please.
Can we have the novelty cheque?
So much for you to get involved. It really is a great cause, and you know,
right
to know
there.
That we've raised $1 million for anti-bullying is amazing. So, what did you girls get up to then? You made a video.
Yes, I made a video. I'm sorry.
You made a video. Oh, yes. good stuff. Well, thank you very much for coming down today. And now we've got a special treat come right up now. Please welcome Mr. Jerry Springer.
Must have been him.
It was the Irishman.
Yeah, he was hugging the other. Hi, Harry. How are you?
Come on. Good. Nice to meet you. Have a good over here. Have a good over here. Hi, guys.
It wouldn't be the first time I was hit by a pig.
We'll come see you guys in a little bit, all right?
All right, why don't you guys have a seat here, okay? We're going to play a game.
Okay.
Harry, why don't you sit over here? Okay. And Louis, why don't you sit here?
Okay. All right. Jerry Springer.
And we have Niall up there. Everybody's got it. Liam, you're up there.
I'm right.
Zane, you're over there. Okay. Welcome to our one big 1D quiz. Okay. Oh, this is going to be unbelievable. And Harry, it's we got music too. Harry, it's great to see you again. You were great on my show last week.
Thank you.
This was great.
I still don't know who the father is.
You don't know who the father
is?
No,
I don't.
Well, first of all, none of you guys could be on my show because you're One Direction, and on my show, all the guys go both directions. So
that see what he's doing now, boys?
Yeah. See what's happening here?
Jerry.
And just before we get started. Just before we get started, so I'm going to give you an opportunity to introduce your teammates. I just got to say, I'm going to get a little bit emotional here, and I don't really want to, but Louis, I got to tell you something. Where are you? 20 years ago, some 20 years ago, I was in Doncaster. Louis, I was in Doncaster. And it was just one night, and I'm your grandfather. Come on, give me some love. Give me some love.
I've been waiting all my life for this.
Say hi to Jen. Is my daughter here? Where is she? Bring out your family. God bless her. I'm sorry. I never send a check. I feel horrible, and Mom, but anyway, I'm very proud of, I am proud of what you've done.
Thank you,
and I'm gonna visit you. I'm gonna visit you.
You're the best grand that I could have asked for, Jerry.
Yes.
Thank you.
We are now gonna play the game. Okay. Will you each introduce your teammates, because we have five teams here, as you can see. We're gonna play three games. Okay. And you get points for how well you do. So why don't we start with you, Harry? Who are your two?
I have Becca and Joanna.
You have
my team, and our team name is We're the Bestest.
We're the Bestest.
We're the Bestest.
Yes. That's an incredible. And where are you guys from, Joanna? Where are you from?
England.
You're from England. I've heard of it. And Becca.
Raleigh, North Carolina.
Raleigh. Oh, okay. And by the way, I should tell you that all of the contestants here, all of the fans, you won competitions to be their teammates. Right?
Yes, we did, yes.
Okay. All right. And Zane, who are you?
I have Haley and Aisha.
Haley and Aisha, okay. And what did you guys do to win?
We were in the Office Depot contest.
You were in the Office Depot contest, okay. And you had to write a letter or something and say why they should pick you?
We made individual videos.
You made individual videos. Well, great, okay. And Liam, who are you?
Here, we've got the lovely Charlotte and Johanna, and they have assured me that we are going to win, so.
You guys are going to win. Yes.
You better be ready.
And Niall?
I've got Nicole and Vanessa with me, and we're going to win, actually.
Yeah.
You're going to win.
No, you see? You heard of her.
Have you got a team name now?
Well, in the end, you're going to fight it out, so I'll feel at home. And finally, you're...
I have Lily and Camilla, and our team name is Jerry's Grandchildren.
Now the will gets more expensive. It gets more expensive. Okay, here's what we're going to do. The first game is called... Oh, this is good. Apparently, it's one of your songs, All the Little Things, right? Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to put it up on the screen. You're going to get some pictures. And we're going to give you a close-up of what you're looking at. It's going to be such a close-up that it's going to be difficult. It's going to be difficult to figure out exactly what it is. You will write down on your white pads there, on the whiteboards, what you think that this picture is. All these little things will give you 3 points if you get it right. Here is the first picture.
Come on, guys. Right.
Can you think of fork?
What?
Any ideas?
Good Lord, what is that?
Okay, I know.
No. It's something very close to you guys. Okay, and I will hear a clang which says that time's up.
Is it
from the video?
Is it like a picture of her?
Like maybe like some of the denim jacket.
Well, write it down and we'll see how you do.
Is it from the video? This is deceiving, because actually that screen shows up blue, remember? So we look at that one over there. Look, they're a different colour.
That would be funny, but are you trying to help with the teams out?
Oh, that's critical.
What is it from the video? That's the question I need to ask.
Oh, there's the thing. Okay, there are no clues.
I have no idea, but I'm going to go with our answer.
You're going to... Okay, what did you write as your answer?
I think it's my T-shirt.
You think it's your T-shirt?
Yeah.
Okay, and what did you... And Zane?
We don't have an answer yet.
You don't have an answer yet.
You're not going to win like that.
Zane?
We think it might be the spirally bit in the video where we, like, walk around in a circle, I think.
Very good. You said that. Bit, yeah. Okay, what are you saying?
We've gone for Zane's jacket. She seems to think she knows what she's doing, so I've gone for it.
It's like shoulder.
Come on, Charlotte.
Oh,
let me know.
Think it's one of the guys' jackets.
Is it the shadow of a giraffe?
And you only get one answer. Harry.
Nobody.
And go. Niall, what is that?
I said Louis' T-shirt.
Louis' T-shirt. And Louis, you said...
I've gone Zane / my jacket. I know that's probably not allowed, but it's tough.
It could be.
I made my own rule. Okay. It's my show. So.
You guys are very perceptive. The correct answer is... Here it comes.
Here it comes. What is it?
Was actually going to say that. That's Loki.
It's Loki, Liam's dog.
Loki
Who
is your dog.
The video
you
thing?
Can't even recognize your own dog.
I was going to say, but I don't know what.
Because you don't care about your dog.
Damn it!
It's on the show next week.
Next question.
Jerry!
What's the next item?
Let's have a look.
All these little things. And the next item is...
This picture's going to come up right now.
It's really going to come up.
Please come up.
Surely.
When this game started, I was young. Okay. What is that?
It's a microphone.
It's a microphone. It's a close-up of something that you...
I'm going to say... A microphone.
Oh.
It looks like...
Oh.
Shoot myself
down. Oh, this is easier. This you should get.
I reckon we should...
Harry, if you don't get this one... Loser.
Hey, Jerry, that's me.
It's been a long day, actually, yeah.
Okay. Do we have a clang?
Let's just go.
That's it. Let's hear it for the horn. Okay, Harry, what you put?
Let's go to someone else first,
okay,
we?
I'll go to someone else
Thanks,
first, because I owe Harry. Zane?
We put microphone.
You say it's a microphone. What do you say?
I'm for Mick.
You say the mic too.
Microphone.
You say the microphone.
No, I'm not sure, mate.
And you say the microphone. So only Harry couldn't get
Harry,
the right answer, which is.
No, we said microphone.
Late.
What? No.
No.
Oh, you got it in time? There you go. Okay.
Well done, guys. That makes
all right.
It.
Well done.
And one more picture. One more picture. Then we're going to the next game.
Right.
I should tell you that the thing you win after this game is unbelievable.
What is it?
I don't know. It's unbelievable.
That's what I said.
Yeah. Okay. I couldn't believe it. What's this last item?
Okay, let's see.
This is going to be great.
Somebody's belly.
That's my ass.
What is that?
I'm going to say.
What is this?
There's only one person that's white.
It's an elbow.
It's definitely me.
Yeah, that's an elbow, right?
Oh my God! I thought I'm looking in a mirror. All right. There was the. What do you? What did you put, Harry?
We have decided. We think it's Niall's elbow.
Niall's elbow. Wow. Very good. I have no idea. I've never seen his elbow. I don't get that close to him.
It's over there.
Well, I see where Niall's sitting, but it's covered up. How do you know what his elbow looks like?
We, we bumped.
Zane, what do you got?
I've got Harry's elbow.
Everyone's going for an elbow.
What is it?
Okay, Harry's elbow. What do you think? You were so good in identifying your dog.
Jerry, let it go, man. I've gone for Niall's elbow as well.
Oh, how predictable. Elbows.
Everyone's
my elbow.
Going with elbows.
Okay, I've gone with bottom half of Niall. Just to be clear, that's not his penis. That is just Niall's legs and other bottom
well,
half.
Well, on him, it wouldn't be the bottom.
Yes. Let's wait and see what that is.
Yeah, so let's wait. Okay, the correct answer is...
I think it's Liam's elbow.
Oh! Very good!
Paddy's elbow! Paddy's one of our security guys.
It's one of the security guys.
There he is over there.
Where's Paddy? Let me see. Let's come on. Let's look at that.
Come on, Paddy.
Come on out here.
Bring him in.
Look at that.
Look at this big,
Paddy, look at that elbow. Look at that. Oh, my God.
Show us your elbow.
If you shave your head, you could be security on my show.
I don't need one, Matt. You're not taking him off me. He's my security guard.
Okay.
How dare you?
All right. Is that's it for this game, right? We're going to game two.
What?
Oh, how many points? You got everyone that got it right got
we
3 points.
Three.
So how do we do
we
on
all
three?
Have three?
Everyone has 3 points. Zane, gee, that's interesting.
Liam up six.
How does that
Zane
work?
Zane has 3 points.
You know, we could have not played this game and it would have been tied 0-0. What's the difference?
Louis has 3
Let's
points.
Let's play the next
Harry
game.
Harry has 3 points.
That's not fair.
This game is speaking of security guards, this guy is like your daddy. I know we've spoken about grandpa.
You're my granddaddy.
He's the tour daddy. I'm your granddaddy. This is your tour daddy. Give it up for Paul Higgins. The bodyguard of armor, our honor. Where are you, Paul?
Where is
Paul?
He's a diva. He's not here.
Paddy.
He's coming.
Use the other Irishman.
Oh, he wants
Paddy,
a big entrance. We don't have Paul?
Come on.
We really don't have Paul.
This is wasting time!
Okay.
Come on, Paddy.
Again.
Come on.
Well, we have Paddy. How you doing, Paddy? We have Paul. Here's Paul. Paul was... No, it's not his fault. He was going...
Paul's Paddy off. Good call there.
Hey, Paddy.
Okay.
Paul.
There he is.
Paul, Paul, where
moment,
were you?
Paul. This is your
this
moment.
This is your big moment. Hi, Paul. How are you? Stand right over here. It's very nice to meet you. Yeah, you're wearing makeup or they have obviously haven't finished.
Yeah. No makeup.
The good point is if you go bald, just turn your face upside down, you'll have hair. Hey, tell me, Paul, what? So you're like in charge of these guys when they're on the road, right?
Correct.
Okay, which is the toughest guy to deal with?
Literally.
Oh, everyone go, my grandson. Are you kidding me? He really is the problem,
Paul,
right?
I've just found out that Jerry's my granddad. Today is a tough day. Okay?
So I can bail you out. Okay, here's the deal. This is what we're going to do. Part of your job is, you know, they're always screaming young people around them, right? So your job is to try to get them through to wherever they have to go. Get them through the crowd. So this is what I'm going to ask you to do, Paul. I'm going to ask first all of you to decide how long it's going to take, in minutes or seconds, to carry every single one of these guys, one at a time, all the way to the band.
Wow.
So he's got to carry five of you.
So he picks and takes us.
He takes you and you stay there. Then you run back, get the next one. So all you, the five guys, you guys are going to line up.
How do we
here.
Get back from there?
I don't know. Take a bus.
Okay, okay.
Why am I in charge? Okay.
Yeah.
So.
We did it to you.
My problem is they're all a pain in the ass.
Yes. Okay, so Paul, you ready? You can do this.
I just have to pick up.
Well, okay, so if the five guys, if you guys will just stand up here. Yeah. Come on.
Okay.
Okay.
Come on,
line up.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
We'll go far. Yeah.
Okay. I'm only asking you to take one direction here. What? Prediction. Oh, you got to write down the prediction first. How long do you think it's going to take him? How long do you think it's going to take for him to carry all five of you?
Where
have
you got to go?
Pardon?
Where's he got to go to?
To the band. Drop you. Come back. Get the number two, number three, number four, number five.
How long have you got?
I was told to drop you.
Okay.
That's not my choice.
Okay. Are we ready? Everyone, put down what they think the number's going to be. Harry, you can win this one.
I can't win anything.
Hello.
I'm just one of the carriers.
Yeah, well, no, you can if you pick the right time.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so you can win.
That's true.
Right, come on, let's crack up.
Okay, what's the line? Here's the line, there you go.
First, so you can get
okay. On your mark, and who's got the clock? Someone watching the time here. Okay.
Don't worry, we'll block it.
I've got to wait by
you. Okay. On your mark, and watch where you put your hands. One, on your mark, get set, go! There you go, look at him go! Yeah. There you go. Oh, he's spun. You can do it, Louis. You can do it. Everyone coming. Everyone's on your side, Louis. Oh! Time's running out. Here we go. Go, go, Harry! Oh! Wow! Oh, my God! That was the whole show. That was the whole show, Harry. Okay. Can we? Okay, I'll tell you what. Okay, can we then see this in slow motion? That last dive. It's worth the whole show. We've got it. I'm going to tell you that the winning time. Well, who had the time was 42 seconds. Who are you? Who had? Oh, isn't that funny?
No, we had 41.
You actually had 40 for real. He really had it. You guys cheat. You're close. 40 is closer to 42. So sorry, Niall. Zane, you're it. 40 seconds, Zane wins. Let's get an instant replay. Watch the instant replay. Oh! Unbelievable.
Oh. Great dive. 6.5, Jerry.
Yes. Okay, so they went 3 points. You guys got 3 points for that. You're in first place. This is unbelievable. I'm getting all emotional thinking about it. You guys have, as you know, a lot of young fans. So we picked three solid young fans of yours, and they are going to describe one of you. You have to write down on your whiteboard who you think that person is describing. So let's go to one of your young fans. You guys are going too young.
Okay. I wonder, will it ever come here? Aren't we great at VTs? VTs, we're great.
VTs,
we're just so good at them. It's great. Can we get top at all?
There's another one coming.
Okay.
Why don't I be one of the toddlers? Okay, is that the wrong VT? There we go.
Nice, man. Oh, he's a bad man. I think girls don't like him. He plays at night time. In London, he lives. I don't like his clothes.
I heard.
What? Yeah, it was hard to hear. It was hard to hear, but frankly, you weren't listening anyway. What? Who were they describing? Write down who you think they were describing. I heard the part where they said, I don't like him.
Yeah, that's why I went with
Simon Cowell, okay.
Is he not one of us?
It's got to be one of you. Yeah. You said Niall.
Didn't know that part.
Okay, who are you writing? It's one of you five. You said Liam. You said Liam. Liam, what is going on here? Why don't these guys like you?
I said Batman.
I said Zane because he's the biggest Batman I know.
You said Batman.
I thought Batman.
Batman.
Yeah. You're a bad man anyway, Zane.
Yeah.
A good man.
Okay. Well, let's see who it was. They will now tell you who they were talking about or show you. They will, I swear.
Howie!
Harry, you're a bad man.
Did you see the one picking his nose?
Yeah.
It was Harry!
Yeah. All right.
Now I'm picking.
Here's another young fan. Next.
Listen carefully, guys. Playing Tiger. I think he wants TV all day. I think he's 40. I think he's thinking of troop trains. And the colouring on his arms. And he's this face like this. And not just.
He's got colouring on his arms.
All right. Okay.
I think he's 40.
Which one? Who's 40? Who do you say it is? You said Zane.
Zane, you look 40.
This is clear.
Zane. Zane. He's got colouring on his arms.
He's got colouring. And it's got to be Zane, because you're the only one with colouring on your tattoos.
Wait, see, we get it wrong.
Let's see, who is it?
I think he can sing. Zane.
Yeah.
Zane!
Yeah. Zane. That's good. Everybody gets 3 points. I hope you're keeping score.
You look
and by
40.
The way, we should give a shout out here to the Weston Park Nursery in Crouch End, London.
Yeah.
These kids, yeah, great kids. Do we have one more?
Competition winners will be winning the children.
Let's take another one.
Let's take one more.
One more. We have one more. Let's take one more.
He looks like a funny person. I think he's been to space. Clever. He looks a bit silly. I think he looks for treasure.
I think he plays blue sport. I think he does the cleaning at my house.
I didn't hear a word of that.
I didn't hear what they said.
Have you got time to play one more time, Ben, or not? Be honest. One more time for the VT or not?
Hear any of that.
Could someone hear?
Let's take it one more.
Can we turn it up?
Can we turn it up, please?
He looks like a funny person. I say he's been to space. Clover, he looks a bit silly. I think he looks for treasure. I think he plays blue sport. I think he does the cleaning at my house.
I think he does the cleaning house. At my house.
They think this one of you incredible. Looks like a cleaning lady.
I know exactly who this is, Jerry.
Okay, who do you say looks like the cleaning lady? We'll start with you, Louis.
Louis.
You look like a cleaning lady, Frank.
Maybe.
Do you do windows?
I do windows, yeah. I do all
Thursday.
Sorts. Grandad.
I'm making my own
Louis. Oh, my gosh, Louis. Oh, Niall.
Thanks.
Yeah, I've got purple hair.
Oh, yeah, maybe it is.
Should we get the answer?
The correct answer is...
We need to kick the ball like that. Louis.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. I like a clean.
Okay.
Louis, you can kick the ball back, though.
Look,
I think we all got it right.
Everybody got it right.
Apart
all right.
From Zane's team.
Here, we have a tie. Who are the two? Who are the two at the top?
I've got Zane and Liam.
Zane and Liam, please come forward. And if you will bring your teammates with you, because teammates, you're going to play a role in this. You young ladies are going to play a role in this.
Yeah, well.
Okay, we have Joanna, and we have Charlotte, and we also have Haley, and we have Asha. Okay, I just want to see your name. Okay, here's what you're going to do. We are going to put up, there are the pictures of the five guys, right? All right. We are going to blindfold you guys, or you two, the teammates. I want you to blindfold the guys.
Oh,
okay.
That's what that was for.
That's what that was for.
I've been using it as a rubber.
Okay.
Maybe I should.
Yeah. It's a great rubber.
Okay.
Blindfold me. Go.
Now go ahead. Blindfold him. This is your chance. Okay. And you're going to then turn them around and around and around, and your direction, one at a time. This is called one direction. You have to direct them.
You have to direct me now, though.
You have to direct them, saying forward, left, to the right, because they have to place their hair on their head. And the one who gets closest wins. So we'll start off here. I'll just say, let's start off with Zane. All right?
So where do you want me first?
Now, you two have to direct him. First, spin him around four times.
Yeah, here?
Spin him around four times. Do it five times, because there are five guys that make the one direction. All right.
Same time, Jerry, same time.
Well, no, because one at a time, otherwise they won't hear the directions. All right. Okay, now go. Okay, shh.
Okay, this way.
Okay, you go. Tell them. Now listen. Go. You got to go forward.
Shh.
Don't touch him. You only give directions.
I look like a cat.
Right, right. Stay where you are.
Okay, you can't go any further. You can just give verbal.
Okay, a little bit
to the
left.
Left?
Not that far left.
This
one?
Right
there.
Perfect. Put it on. And it's on.
Okay. To the right, to the right. Perfect.
Whoa.
There you go.
Cool.
Okay, we have to have a ruling. And the ruling has to be the first time it touches the board, it has to stay there. Okay? So. Okay, now follow me, Zane. You're going back to your, you go back to the puppet. You can now take it off.
Yeah? Cool.
You can take it off. All right, now let's spin around. Did he spin around five times?
Get you.
Oh, no, spin, okay. Okay. Leave me going around five times, William. This is good. Oh, this is good. You have no idea where you are. Okay, you can't touch him. You can only say, go forward, to the left, whatever, go.
Right, turn left a little bit.
Okay.
Turn left a little bit, right. Now walk forwards.
Time's come, play with
Tweedies. Oh.
Right, now turn left a little bit.
Don't touch him. Forwards. There's no touching. There's no touching.
Forwards. Right, now go to the right.
Okay, now.
Step to the right.
And a right again. Right again. Right again. Forward now. Forward. Straight.
Go. That's it.
Six.
Got it. All right. That's it. Okay. You can take the blindfold off.
Yeah.
Now, who is? Well, this is good. If this looks like the wind blew your hair. And this looks like you got a mustache.
Yeah.
So we're going to say, who's closest by the audience? Who do you think's closest?
Liam! Zay!
Liam's pretty good.
They both win, Jay!
You know what? The prize. What's the prize? There's no
happiness.
Prize? How cheap is this show?
Shut up,
they don't even have a prize.
We flew
here, you know what? Nah.
We flew you business, Jerry.
Here you go. It's $20. It's American money.
Yes.
There you go. Congratulations. A final thought. Where do I go for a final thought?
Come on.
I just got to give my grandson one more hug.
Oh, it's been emotional, Jerry,
yeah,
but...
No. Have your mother call me. I've neglected her.
Okay.
There's your stool, Jerry.
Where's my stool? At my age, don't say stool. Pardon? Yeah.
Never not loved that.
No, but it's good because as I get old and start forgetting things, the repetition, I know who I am. Yeah. Okay, I just want to take this opportunity to congratulate the winners of the competition. And to the guys who lost, well, maybe singing will work out. I'd give that a shot. But clearly, there are lessons to be learned from your songs, and it's not just all the little things.
Jerry, you minx!
But a call to live while we're young. So how about a shout out to us old folks who we like to live too?
Yeah.
I mean, come on, come on.
Yeah.
I mean, watching you guys is a treat, but it's more than this.
Yeah.
It's one thing.
Yeah.
I want.
Yeah.
I want your talent. Yeah. That's what makes you beautiful.
Yeah.
There are a lot of great acts around today, but if you're talking pop music, where do you go? There's only one direction. Take care of yourself and each other.
I think it's our eighth hour now. We were supposed to be off air ages ago, but that's how much One Direction love you.
Yeah.
It's true. We could go all night. Should we go all night?
Yeah.
We might as well. We're here now. Oh, crazy time.
It's anarchy.
Yeah.
Party.
Okay, now the guys are going to get ready for a very special performance in just a moment. But first, let's see the lovely fans from Singapore. Very impressive. Thank you very much, Singapore. And possibly better than the boys' version. Right, we are nearly at the end of 1D Day. This has been the best thing ever. It's been for the fans, and we've absolutely loved you watching us. So many people still getting in touch. Hannah Lovell with her masks. Marie Gedder says, I don't have potatoes, but I have French fries. Neve Porter says, one big potato. That's for Niall from Donegal in Ireland. Shannon Callahan has done a potato selfie as well. There's so many. Just a sign of potatoes because they've got none left. That's from Elisa. So many good messages coming in. Literally just turned 16. I'm from England. That's from KG. Don't know if I can stay up until 2 a.m. I think you're doing really well. Who else have we got here? One big selfie. That's from Humrik. Me and my best friends in my room just now. We love you so much, guys. Food and live stream equals fun. Agus Malik says, one big selfie. That's Argentina loving One Direction. Watching 1D Day with my sisters, chilling with my girls from Los Angeles. That's Elisa. And Natey says, we're getting crazy. It's all we need. We've been watching for hours and hours, but it's still going. It really is. We are nearly at the end of 1D Day. So thank you so, so much. If you got in touch, if you've been watching us, we are gearing up, though, for one last performance, which is going to happen in just a few moments. First of all, let's go and see the brilliant fans from Canada.
Sam from Canada's number one entertainment show, eTalk. Well, I'm not sure if you remember, but I most certainly do. Last year, we were backstage with you guys during your tour stop here in Toronto. It was so much fun, and it was a huge hit. And you know what? Now I'm about to show you how Canada is planning on celebrating One Direction Day. You have had an amazing year so far, and we're about to cap it all off with a huge surprise just for you guys. Are you ready? It took our team months and months of planning. No peeking. Are you ready? Ta-da! There you go, guys. The first ever One Direction float, and here you are, over 9 feet tall, each of you. You know, that is a whole lot of One Direction to take in. We don't mind, though. If you notice your snazzy little outfits, these are actually the exact same outfits that you wore for your film premiere for This Is Us. How cool is that? This float also gives a great nod to all things British. We've got the Tower Bridge over here. And of course, we can't forget about the iconic classic telephone booth. And if you think it looks familiar, it's because it bears a striking resemblance to the one that you featured on your sophomore disc, Take Me Home. Now, this 1D float actually made its debut at the 109th Annual Santa Claus Parade, which is the longest running children's parade in the world, and it was broadcast across the globe. That is amazing. As we are so excited for Midnight Memories, we have got our fingers and toes crossed, hoping that you plan to visit Canada soon. In the meantime, we wish you a very Merry Christmas and an extraordinary 1D day.
Is an incredible float. We're all blown away by that. Thank you so much, Canada. Now, I think it has to be said that what you've all put together, and I mean around the world for 1D Day, has been incredible. All I did for 1D Day was just get on a plane and talk a bit, but next year I'll do better. Anyway, whatever. Thank you so much for getting in touch, for watching us, for the whole, whatever. How long have we been on air now? 16 years. Final word to the boys. How's it been for you?
We've really enjoyed it. And we were just saying there before we came back, when that VT was playing, we really enjoyed our day today. And it was really fun. Thanks very much for coming out.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Scott.
I've enjoyed it.
Me too.
It's been really good.
It's fun, right?
Enjoyed
it's been
boys?
Wicked.
Yeah, yeah, I think mate. We just want to say a general thank you to all the guests that we've had today. It's been absolutely amazing. And everyone who's watched, really.
Yeah, and that last VT with that float thing there incredible. Was pretty
amazing,
ace.
Wasn't it?
Yeah.
And
also a massive thank you to the crew who worked on this show, because we know
thank you. A lot of people put this together. So thanks so much to the crew for one
thank
day.
You to all our celebrity guests, Wrong Direction, Jerry Springer, Simon Cowell, everyone who came onto the show. Thank
Dynamo.
You so much.
Dynamo, yeah.
Okay, so
we have one final guest as a special treat for you. He is a Grammy Award-winning singer from Canada. He has 11 albums, and he's now going to sing along with the guys from One Direction. This is live, so it might not work. If it does, it's a bonus. Everybody, it's the fantastic Michael Bublé with One Direction.
We get some arm sways.
It's been really good.
It's fun, right?
Enjoyed
it's been
boys?
Wicked.
Yeah,
yeah
I think
mate.
We just want to say a general thank you to all the guests that we've had today. It's been absolutely amazing. And everyone who's watched, really.
Yeah, and that last VT with that float thing there
incredible.
Was pretty
amazing,
ace.
Wasn't it?
And
yeah.
also a massive thank you to the crew who worked on this show, because we know
thank you. A lot of people put this together. So thanks so much to the crew for one
thank you
day.
To all our celebrity guests, Wrong Direction, Jerry Springer, Simon Cowell, everyone who came onto the show. Thank
Dynamo.
You so much.
Dynamo, yeah.
Dynamo.
Where is he?
So we have one final guest as a special treat for you. He is a Grammy Award-winning singer from Canada. He has 11 albums, and he's now going to sing along with the guys from One Direction. This is live, so it might not work. If it does, it's a bonus. Everybody, it's the fantastic Michael Bublé with One Direction.
We get some arm sways.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear the sleigh bells in the snow. Oh,
wearing bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
Hey, let's do it! Come on, let's go, boys! Here we go! Yeah. Give it up for the lad!
Set 1D date, One Direction since inception, to the top, that's where we going.
Breathe. Good luck, girls. So excited.
The story of my life, I take her home, I drive all night to keep her warm in time. It's frozen.
Give it up for Dynamite.
Dynamite, everybody!
Hey, what's going on?
Yeah. One card.
Oh,
like
I'm excited about what's going down here.
He knows he's done seven it.
He knows he's done it.
Cindy Crawford.
It's only
oh my God.
We're here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yeah!
A peacock.
A peacock. That's nice.
I want to see your peacock.
Well, I know,
the sun will be rising. Liam, didn't I hear recently that you had your pants stolen in North
Mate,
Australia?
Mate, I did have my pants stolen.
Yeah.
We could just scare them.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop!
Love it.
Work it, baby.
Old man with a big sack, popular at this time of the year, is called
Alberto.
Extra larges. It's on the extra larges. Stop!
It's one knee day, Buble. One knee day, everybody.
I know that feeling.
Okay, is he a singer?
Everything tastes good when it's deep fried.
I've had some salt and vinegar ones these for my sister.
Okay, grasshopper doesn't taste good.
Wow! Oh my God!
There are a lot of great acts around today, but if you're talking pop music, where do you go? There's only one direction. Take care of yourself and each other.
Everybody, it's the fantastic Michael Bublé with One Direction!
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
With every Christmas card.